Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Coding with Vakar. I'm your friend Vakar and we are learning how to create an e-commerce website with WordPress. In this video, we will learn how to set up your online store using WooCommerce and how to create and add categories and attributes. Let's go to your WordPress dashboard and click on WooCommerce. Just wait. Enter your store address. I'm writing ABC Road, Karachi, Pakistan. You can enter whatever the address of your store. Select your city. I'm selecting Pakistan. Then select if you are from other country, like you are from Germany, then click Germany. If you are from Pakistan, then click Pakistan and select your state with country, then click your city, Karachi, and whatever the postcode of your area, enter that. I'm entering the fake one for testing purpose only. If you are creating the store from your client, then check this option. I'm learning, that's why I'm leaving this empty. Click continue. It will ask you to build a better WooCommerce. Click no thanks. It will sending you emails on your email. What your store about? Fashion, apparel, accessories, health and beauty, electronics, computer. Select according to yourself and your store. I'm selecting fashion, apparel and accessories. Click continue. It asking that your products are physical products or downloadable, like software and other songs and videos. No, our store is physical products. Click continue. Click this. How many products do you plan to display? I'm selecting 11,200. You can select according to your store. It will ask you currently selling elsewhere. Click no. Click continue. If you want to recommend business feature to your site, then check this box. Otherwise, leave this box empty. Click continue. It will ask you to select other themes for WooCommerce purpose. We have already selected our theme, Flatsome theme. Click continue with my active theme. Now our WooCommerce setup has been done. Then click on settings. Ignore this message. You can also write or edit the address line, city and other fields. If you want to select all the countries in the world and leave this option set, sell to all countries. If you want to sell specific countries, you can select this option and enter the countries by name. Like I'm only selling Pakistan, then click only Pakistan. If you want to sell outside of the Pakistan, like USA, or Australia, then click this. If you want to sell all the countries, then click set to all countries. Currency, we have set up our currency by default Pakistan rupees. If you are set up the website for client USA client, then click US currency like dollar. I am going with Pakistan rupees. This is the amount separator, thousand separator, decimal separator. You can choose according to your. Click save changes. After saving the changes, go to products. What should be your shop page? By default, we leave the shop page shop. Leave this all field as it is. Go to shipping. Once we have start creating our products, then we create our shipping methods. For this time, leave this. Go to payments. How would you get your payment? Direct bank transfer or cash on delivery? Or if you have a other payment option, you have to first install by using plugin, then it will shown here. And for learning purpose, we are going with direct bank transfer and cash on delivery. Click direct bank account, enable. Also click cash on delivery. Click direct bank transfer setup. Enter your bank account details like ABC bank, and account number is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. You enter according to your bank account information. Bank name ABC bank, sort code IBAN number and SWIFT number. What is your bank account details? You have to enter this. After putting the bank account information, click save changes. If you have more than one account, you can click add account and enter the details accordingly. I am going with one bank account and click save changes. Then go to account and privacy. This is how you handle your customer. Customer needs to log in before purchasing anything. It's all default. By default, it's check allow customer to place order without an account. No, we don't allow to customer to purchase any item without login. Allow customer to log in existing account during checkout. Yes. Allow customer to create an account during checkout. Yes. Allow customer to create an account on my account page. Yes. You can choose this option according to you. Then click save changes. Remaining things by default we leave as it is. Then go to emails. This is the email that you have received or your customer receive once he or she place an order. I am leaving this setting as it is. Go to integration. This is the database file of the backend. If you have MaxMind license key, you can enter geolocation. I am leaving this blank because we are not setting up this. Now our WooCommerce has been set up successfully. Click save changes. Then go to products. Here is our products. Click on categories. This is our product category page where we create and add categories. By default, you have one category named uncategorized. you cannot this category by default, but you can rename or update this category. Click on quick edit. Let's create a credit like men's. And also the slug is the URL of your category. Click update category. Now our category has been updated. Go to the demo website, shop mini big. From that we have copied the categories and products. We have three parent categories: kids, men's, women's. In men's category we have shirts, pants and shoes. Let's create it. Go to your WordPress page, click shirt, select your parent category men's, click add new category. Enter a new category called pants. Click add new category. Then enter shoes category. Click add new category. Now we have entered three categories in men's section: shoes, pants and shirts. We also have a shirts, pants in kids, women's. That's why we set the parents. We have child category, shirt, pant, shoes in main three categories. We are differentiating these categories by parents, kids, men's and women's. You can enter more categories by setting up this method. Enter a new category, women's. It will our parent category. Parent category none. Then click on add new category. Now women's category has been added. Click on pants. Then click our parent category women's. Click add new category. Click shoes, then add category, then add shirts. Now add the parent category of kids. Set parent category as none. Click add new category. Add pants in kids section. Set parent category as kids. Click add new category. Click shoes, click add new category. Click pants, add new category. Now our all categories has been added and created. Then go to attributes. Attributes, you can say that attributes is a additional information about particular product. Like if we are selling the t-shirts or pants, the attribute will be color, size, its length. If you are selling other things like shoes, then its attribute will be size also. Now we are on the attribute page. Click attribute names, like I'm entering the color attribute. You don't need to put the slug here or enable archives. You need to leave this by default. Just click add attribute after giving the name of attribute. Just wait a while. Now our color attribute has been added. Let's add one more attribute, size. Click add attribute. Now we have added two attributes, color and size. Let's click on configure terms in color section, where we are giving the color names, whatever the color you have according to your product. Enter colors. I am selecting blue. Click add new color. Click red. Click add new color. I have added two colors, red and blue. Coming back to the attributes. Now we have two attributes by color, blue and red. Go to size, click on configure terms. After coming in the size attributes, give size accordingly. Your store, your product. I'm giving a small attribute, small size attribute. Click add new size. I'm adding medium size. You can unlimited sizes, whatever size you of your product you have, you can add this. Now we have done with categories and attributes. In this video, we have learned how to set up the WooCommerce for our online store, how to add categories and how to add attributes. In the next video, we will learn how to design your own logo. I will be waiting for you guys to join me in next video. Before going, click the subscribe and like button.